This program was paid for by Water of Life Church. From Water of Life Ministries in Plano, Texas, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob is speaking through his servants to the world. He that hath ears to hear, let him hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying today. Let us join Doyle Davidson and others of Water of Life, sowing the Word of God in spirit and in truth.
Hello, I'm Doyle Davidson, servant and apostle of the Lord Jesus Christ, ministering locally to the body of Christ in Dallas, Fort Worth, Texas, sent by God to your house to declare unto you the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank God. 1 Corinthians 15, 3 and 4 tell us what the gospel is. Now that Jesus Christ died for our sins, according to Scripture, he is buried. He rose again the third day, according to the Scripture. Thank God. Spirit of the Lord is upon me. She's anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor, sent me to heal the broken heart, preach deliverance to the captives, come with sight to the blind, set at liberty them that are bruised. Thank God, word is nigh thee, in thy heart, in my mouth, is the word of faith which I preach. You confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus, believe with your heart that God raised him from the dead, you shall be saved. With the heart, man believeth unto righteousness. With the mouth, confession is made unto salvation. Thank God. Amen. Amen. Thank God. Amen. Thank God. Thank God. I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Christ. It is the power of God unto salvation. Everyone that believeth. James verse also, to the Greek, there is the righteousness God revealed from faith to faith, as it is written, just to live by his faith. Thank God. I want to welcome everyone receiving this on live stream, Roku, Apple TV, YouTube, and other devices. Kathie Davidson, co-host to my left. Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you?
Doing all right.
I want y'all to join us with some recorded songs by Bella Apostle, who went to heaven in January 09. Terry by with me, nearly 30 years. And his anointed songs, his faith, my anointing, my faith is also on his songs, mixed with my faith is a joy to fight the devil and overcoming. Let's worship, join Terry by anything. Oh,
soul rise and be healed in the name of Jesus. Let faith arise in your heart. Rise and be healed in the name of Jesus. He will cleanse you and make your life whole.
He will cleanse you and make your life whole.
He will cleanse you and make your life whole. much longer will it be? Till the Father reaches over, touches Son on the shoulder, and say, Jesus, go bring our family.
stood among the millions, and I stood there all alone. His face was like the sun, his eyes were like the sea, his voice was like the thunder rolling through.
Then my eyes beheld him, and I was in dreaming now. it was dark in my heart. You brought light to me, a child of darkness became a child of light. And when my soul was so
Davidson on deck. Yeah. Okay.
There you are.
All right. I'd like us to turn to Hebrews 10. I'm going to reiterate something that I read last night, part of it, because I want us to go a little further. It says, verse 12, Hebrews 10, but this man, that's talking about Jesus, after he had offered one sacrifice for sins, forever, forever. One sacrifice for sins forever, sat down at the right hand of God, from henceforth expecting till his enemies be made its footstool. For by one offering, what was that offering? His own body and his own blood. His offering. For by one offering he has perfected forever them that are sanctified. Where the Holy Ghost also is a witness to us. For after that he said before, this is the covenant that I will make with them after those days, saith the Lord. I will put my laws in their hearts, and in their minds will I write them, and their sins and their iniquities I will remember no more. And look at verse 18. Now where remission of these is, where the sins are remitted, taken away because of the sacrifice Jesus made. He said, now where remission of these is, there is no more offering for sin. No more offering.
Amen.
This is the word of God, and the word of God cannot be broken. This happened when Jesus went into the holiest of holies after his resurrection with his own blood. And as I shared this week, the Father met him there and received the sacrifice that Jesus brought him. He received the blood that Jesus had with him, and he sprinkled the heavenlies, and there is no more offering for sin than that. But what has to happen to us to receive that offering, to walk in it? I want you to turn to Acts 26. These are remarkable verses, and Doyle has shared these often. And I want us to look at it, because this is the Lord Jesus himself talking to Paul, and he explains to Paul what has to happen to us. It's a wonderful Jesus explaining what has to happen to you and I. He says, first, I'm going to begin in verse 14. Oh, no, let's do it 13. At midday, O king, this is the Apostle Paul speaking. I saw on the way a light from heaven above the brightness of the sun, shining round about me and they that journeyed with me. And we were all fallen to the earth. And I heard a voice speaking to me, and saying in the Hebrew tongue, Saul, Saul, why persecutest thou me? It is hard for thee to kick against the pricks. And I said, who art thou, Lord? And he said, I am Jesus, whom thou persecutest. Now I want you to understand this. Paul wasn't persecuting the man Jesus. Paul was persecuting the people that followed Jesus. And Jesus just told Paul, when you're persecuting them, you're persecuting me. He just told Paul, when you were persecuting these Christians, you were persecuting me.
Amen.
Now, Jesus then goes on, but rise and stand upon thy feet, for I have appeared unto thee for this purpose, to make thee a minister and a witness, both of these things which thou hast seen and those things in which I will appear unto thee, delivering thee from the people and from the Gentiles unto whom I will send thee. And now look what Jesus tells them has to happen to us. Because he's sending Paul to do this. So these things have to happen to us. The first one is to open their eyes. Paul's first job through the Lord Jesus, Jesus working in him, they have to open their eyes. The first thing that has to happen to you is your eyes have to be opened.
Amen.
Turn with me to John 12, verse 37. It says, but when, though he had done so many miracles among them, and it's talking about Jesus, yet they believed not on him, that the saying of Isaiah the prophet might be fulfilled, which spoke, Lord, who hath believed our report, and to whom hath the arm of the Lord been revealed? Therefore they could not believe, because Isaiah saith again, he has blinded their eyes and hardened their heart, that they should not see with their eyes, and they should not understand with their heart, and be converted, and I should heal them. Do you know what happened in Acts 11? I want you to go to Acts 11 real quick. And I want you to go to verse 14. It says, and a certain woman named Lydia, Paul was speaking, preaching. It says, a certain woman named Lydia, a seller of purple in the city of Thyatira, which worshiped God. Now, she worshiped God. She went to church. She worshiped God. But look what God did to her. It says, and heard Paul, whose heart the Lord opened, that she attended to the things that were spoken of by Paul. She worshiped God, but Paul had to get her eyes and her heart open before she could understand. Do you see that? So what Jesus told Paul, the first thing you're going to do is get their eyes open. The first thing that has to happen to us is our eyes have to be open. Now look at the next thing. It says, and to turn them from darkness to light. So first your eyes have to be open. And what are they going to be open to? They're going to be open to the light, to turn them from darkness to light. Go back to John 12. Jesus himself is speaking to Paul, and Jesus is speaking here in John 12. In John 12, verse 44, Jesus cried and said, he that believeth on me, believeth not on me, but on him that sent me. Amen. And he that seeth me, seeth him that sent me. And look at this next verse. I am come a light into the world, and whosoever believeth in me shall not abide in darkness. Who is the light? Jesus is the light. And it talks about the light of the glorious gospel. So first, our eyes have to be open. And then we see the light. We see the gospel. Lydia attended to the things which Paul was speaking. And what was Paul speaking? Amen. What he always spoke, the gospel. She got her eyes open to the light of the gospel, to Jesus. And now what happens? It says, and from the power of Satan unto God. So first the eyes are open. Then we see the gospel. Then to turn them from darkness to light and from the power of Satan unto God. How do we get there? Go with me to Colossians 1. I remember Doyle ministering these verses. And I remember all of us here at Water of Life, speaking these verses aloud, praying these verses. Verse 12. Giving thanks unto the Father, Colossians 1, who has made us made to be partakers of the inheritance of the saints in light. Verse 13, who has delivered us? Who has delivered us? Who? Jesus. Who has delivered us from the power of Satan and has translated us into the kingdom of his dear Son. Has delivered us from the power of darkness. How did he do that? How did he deliver us from the power of darkness into the kingdom of his dear Son? Next verse, in whom we have redemption. That's a ransom. Redemption means ransom.
Thank God.
Who has delivered us from the power of darkness and translated us into the kingdom of his dear Son, in whom we have redemption. The ransom paid through his blood, even the forgiveness of sins. Now, you know what? We're not done yet. It's not done yet. The person's eyes, our eyes are opened. And then we see the light of the glorious gospel. We're taken out of darkness. And then we're delivered from that power of darkness by the blood of Jesus. Redeemed, ransomed out of the power of darkness. But this is what I really want to get to. The next verse. Because there's a marvelous word in this verse. Jesus already died. Jesus already paid for our sins. Jesus already was buried. Jesus already was raised from the dead. Jesus already went into heaven and sprinkled his blood for us in the heavenlies. But we're not done on our side. Look at this next phrase. It says that they may receive forgiveness of sins. But do you know what that word receive means? Have you ever looked that word up? To receive forgiveness of sins. You know what that word actually means? It means to take. It means to take. To take it as your own. To take it. Do you know all this was done for you? Jesus already died on your behalf. He already forgave you. He already paid. There is only one sacrifice for sins, and Jesus paid it. But you have to take it. You have to take it. You have to take it. You can't sit in that pew or that chair in church just waiting for whatever God drops in your lap. The word is take. And the word means seize. And the word means take as your own. You know why that person next to you sins is forgiven? Because they took it. Because they went after it. You know what the word of God says? Do you know what Jesus said? He said, ask. He said, you got to ask. Ask and you'll receive. You got to seek. Seek and you'll find. You got to knock. Knock and it'll be open. But you're the one that's got to ask. And you're the one that's got to seek. And you're the one that's got to go knocking. And you're the one that has to take. It is already done, but you have a job to do on your own part, and that is to take what Jesus did for you. That's your job. That is your job. And you know what happens when you take it? That's believing. That is walking by faith. And you know what? You have to do it every morning. Every morning you have to start your day taking. You have to go after the kingdom. You have to seek it. You have to ask. You have to knock. You have to receive it. You have to believe every day. If you don't advance something on that day, then you're not advancing and you're going backwards. You've got to do it every day. Jesus said, take up your cross daily and follow me. And the first thing you're going to have to do to get your eyes open, to even start on this journey, is you've got to be born again. And we're going to do that at the end. So hang in there, and Doyle will lead you to be born again.
Amen. I want to say this. If you don't want to be a Christian, you're not going to be one.
Absolutely.
If you don't want to walk in the gospel, you're not going to walk in the gospel.
Amen.
If you don't want to live by faith, you're not going to live by faith. You got to have the want to.
Amen.
The desire. And believe, because it's the greatest reward you'll ever receive.
Amen.
We got a song coming up, right?
Amen.
A song by Terre Brown. Terre's been with my ministry since 1985. She's heard my word. She's heard my preaching. She's attended one of my Christian training schools. She knows the truth. She knows what I teach. She knows what I believe. And now she's here to minister a song to you with faith. Derek, tell them what you're going to say.
God on the mountain. Life is easy when you're up on the mountain and you've got peace of mind like you've never known. But then things change and you're down. Don't lose faith, for you're never alone. For the God on the mountain, He's still God in the valley. When things go wrong, He'll make them right. And the God of the and your talk comes so easy. Life's at its best, but it's down in the valley of trials and temptation. That's when your faith is really put to the test. For the God on the things go wrong, He'll make them right. And talk of faith. When you're up on your mountain and your talk comes so easy, life's at its best, but it's down in your valley of trials and temptation. That's when your faith is really put to the test. For the God on the mountain, He's still God in the valley. When things go wrong, He'll make them right. And the God of your good times, He's still God in your bad times. The God of
invite you to visit Water of Life Church at 1621 18th Street in Plano, Texas. Or for further information, call area code 972-578-8082. That's 972-578-8082. Or write Doyle Davidson, Post Office Box 861327, Plano, Texas 75086. That's Doyle Davidson, Post Office Box 861327, Plano, Texas, 75086. This program was paid for by Water of Life Church.